Hi there, my name is Eric. Who are you?
Hi Eric, I'm your virtual assistant. Here to help you with any information or tasks you might need. What can I do for you today?
Tell me a quick joke.
Sure. Here's a quick one for you. Why don't skeletons fight each other? They don't have the guts. Hope that gives you a chuckle.
Nice try. What is the Post Malone song?
Post Malone has a number of popular songs.
How's it? Very impressive. It works by directly linking ChatGPT to this development board so you can have a natural conversation. As you can see, you can continue the conversation without any triggers. Unfortunately, this cannot be done entirely on MCU in a standalone form, so it has to be connected to a server via Wi-Fi. This works very well, and I'm personally very satisfied.
What should I do when I feel bad?
Alright, let's take a look at this board. At the heart of this thing is the T5E1 module powered by Arm Cortex-M33 running at 480 MHz. It's got 8 MB of flash, 16 MB of PSRAM, and built-in Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5.4. So yeah, it's pretty stacked. You've also got a ton of input-output, over 50 GPIOs, plus support for things like SPI, I2C, UART, BWM, CAN, audio input-output, and even camera support. It's got a USB-C port for easier flashing, a microSD card slot, onboard dual microphones. It's basically ready for smart displays, voice, or camera projects right out of the box. Now let's talk about this display. It's a 3.5-inch RGB screen driven by the IRI9488 controller. The resolution is 480x320 and it uses RGB565 color, which gives you some good quality. What's cool is that this board drives it using a native RGB interface, not SPI, so it's way faster and smoother when you're pushing graphics. It also comes with a capacitive touch layer, so you can build interactive UIs and it connects directly to the board without any weird adapters. Now let's power it up and see it in action. I'm just plugging the USB-C cable and you will see the board boot up right away. What's loading here is a demo build with LVGL, which is a lightweight graphics library, perfect for embedded devices like this. I'm pretty sure you are also very familiar with LVGL if you follow my channel. As you can see, the UI is running smoothly. You've got buttons, sliders, and even charts. It's all being rendered directly by the T5AI board with no help from a host PC. This demo is a great example of how polished and responsive you can make the interface, even on a resource-constrained device. Now, here's what really makes this board stand out. It's not just for blinking LEDs or running simple demos. The T5AI board is actually built with modern AI projects in mind. Tuya gives you access to a bunch of intelligent services, things like voice recognition, scene detection, predictive automation, and even the ability to integrate AI agents built on large language models. So you are not stuck building from scratch or hacking things together anymore. With this board and Tuya's platform, you can build projects that you use to fill out a reach, like a smart doorbells, voice-controlled panels or AI chatbots, and get them up and running way faster. These days, everything is shifting toward AI and we are starting to see hardware platforms that are actually built for the future. What's exciting about boards like the T5AI is that they make advanced development feel way more accessible. If we can build powerful AI projects this easily, then we can spend less time wrestling with the hardware and more time focusing on great ideas. Let's see how it goes. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.